Good evening, dear friends, dear students. I once again welcome you to Sayan's Micro Class, Part 5. Now, I owe an apology to you for not being able to come last week since I went somewhere. So, today, in the last class, we studied briefly about fungi. Today, we'll study just a bit interactive way in about fungus. Now, fungus has many beneficial effects in our lives, like wine production, then packing industry, then they are edible also, they are sources of probiotics also. So, in this way, fungus is very helpful to us. And fungus is eukaryotic, not prokaryotic. And fungus, the fruiting body or reproductive unit of fungus, is called conidia, and in case of sporulating fungus, the sexual reproductive unit is called spore. So conidia is an asexual structure while spore is a sexual structure. So conidia is diploid but spore is haploid. Conidia can again be macroconidia or microconidia. Microconidia are responsible for spreading the disease mostly, while macroconidia help in identification of the fungus. There is another type of conidia known as chlamydoconidia or chlamydospore, which is found in Candida albicans as well as Candida dubliniensis. Chlamydospores are double-walled round structures like this. They are double-walled round structures. These are terminal chlamydospores, and sometimes they occur singly, sometimes they occur in multiple manner on top of a pseudohyphae. So, at this point of time, let me tell you what are the good books in microbiology that you might want to consult in regards to bacteriology as well as mycology. So I'll write the names of the books. So the mostly well read books are, of course, the basic book Ananth Narayan and Panikkar's textbook. Another good book is Padija textbook, P. Chakrabarty textbook of bacteriology and mycology. And if you have time, you can read Mackey and McCartney textbook of practical medical microbiology. These are the basic books that you should read. So today we'll start just briefly about parasites. So let me tell you just the introduction of parasites. Parasites can be protozoa and they can be helminths. Protozoa are briefly gut protozoa, free living protozoa, and tissue protozoa, while helminths can be of three types: cestode, nematode, and trematode. Protozoa are prokaryotic, while helminths are eukaryotic. So, in the next classes, we will study more about this classification and the details of protozoa, helminths, and their subclassifications. These are very important: the gut protozoa, tissue protozoa, and the free living protozoa. and the hell means cystodes, nematodes and trematodes. So till then, goodbye. We'll meet again in the next class, and keep commenting, liking my video and subscribe also, and press the bell icon and keep on supporting Sayan's Microbiology.